The Berlin Wall was built to protect East Germany from capitalistic West Berlin, and therefore was called the anti-fascist barrier. Of course, that's only an explanation based on East German propaganda. Let me tell you the real story why the Berlin Wall was built. Coming up. Hi there and welcome to another video of East Germany Investigated, the channel that will dive into the fascinating history of East Germany, formerly known as the German Democratic Republic. We will talk about the former country's biggest secrets, we'll unravel myths and share facts with you that you most probably didn't know. Let's get started. In 1945, after the end of the Second World War, Germany was divided in the zones of the four Allied representative powers. And already after a couple of months, it was forbidden to pass the interzone borders without permission. But given the hundreds of thousands of people that were looking for new homes because their houses were bombed, or they had to relocate because of the new German borders, or they were trying to find out if their relatives had survived the war, it was an impossible task to manage the interzone border crossings. If you want to know more about the reason for the formation of East and West Germany, then check out this video that I made about the split of Germany. A containment of the gigantic flow of refugees going from east to west was in the interest of all Allied parties. The Soviets saw qualified specialist staff bleeding away from the eastern sector, and the Western Allies saw a problem in feeding and medically treating the continuous incoming flow of refugees and finding a place to live for them. So on June 30th, 1946, the demarcation line, the border between the Western and the Soviet zone, going from north to south, was closed. Now, only at a few designated crossing points, the demarcation line could be crossed with the right paperwork. However, obtaining travel authorization was not easy, and it was still relatively simple to cross the border illegally, especially at night. By the way, a few months earlier, UK Prime Minister Winston Churchill had already said that an iron curtain has descended across the continent. In December 1946, the Soviet zone installed the border police. 2,500 men, supported by the Soviet military, guarded the border to the western zones, but also towards Poland and Czechoslovakia, which was of course only leading to a very limited border surveillance. But over the years, the number of staff increased, and by October 1949, when the German Democratic Republic was founded, the total workforce amounted to around 20,000 men already. On March 10, 1952, Joseph Stalin issued a note to the Western Allies in which he proposed a German unification. However, it did not come to an agreement as East and West did not want to accept each other's conditions. West German Chancellor Konrad Adenauer also stated that going with Stalin's plan would endanger West Germany's democracy. So, Stalin's attempt had been unsuccessful, and West Germany had only strengthened its ties with the West, because in 1952 the Germany Treaty, Deutschlandvertrag, was signed, which meant that West Germany would no longer be occupied by the Allies, but be recognized as a sovereign state. This had hardened the fronts between East and West. On the same day that the Germany Treaty was signed in West Germany, the GDR government communicated a new regulation about the order at the demarcation border that resulted in a total closure of the border. Effectively, by October 1952, from North to South Germany, the border was closed by barbed wire and a 10-meter control strip, which was a no-go area. What was left were only 6 railroads and 5 motorways and main roads that still crossed the border. The reason for East Germany closing the border was of course to avoid that more people would leave the Soviet zone, because at that time, a few years after the war, it had become clear that the western part of Germany was the better part to live in. So lots of Germans made use of the possibility to go and live in the western part of the country. In the years that followed, the border installations got more and more sophisticated, with watchtowers, communication systems, signaling installations, alarms, etc. But for people that wanted to leave East Germany, it was still possible to cross the border in Berlin. Because in Berlin there was no border control between the Allied sectors, so you could easily go from the east to one of the west sectors and, for example, fly to West Germany from there. The East German economy was heavily suffering from the loss of so many, especially young people, that created big demands on the job market. and on August 13, 1961, the East German police and army starts closing the East-West Berlin border and in a second step also the rest of the border around West Berlin. At first, kilometers of barbed wire and fences are installed, and in the months that follow, the Berlin Wall becomes a fact. This day, that had started at 1 o'clock in the morning, our ex, had been prepared already for months, and was under the direction of Erich Honecker, the later leader of East Germany. The reaction of the Western Allies and West Germany was mild, and the West Berlin population felt left alone. US President Kennedy stated that putting up a fence illustrates the defeat of the communist system. He also explained that if the Soviets would have wanted West Berlin, they wouldn't have built a wall. It's not a convenient solution, but better than a war, he said. A bizarre fact is that 2 months earlier, East German head of state Walter Ulbricht had said,
"Niemand hat die Absicht, eine Mauer zu errichten,"
which means that nobody has the intention of building a wall. Now that the last remaining gaps were closing, lots of East Germans thought, it's now or never, and went for it. This led to a number of spectacular and dangerous escapes, and unfortunately also to the first deaths at the Berlin Wall. On August 24th, 1961, 24-year-old tailor Günther Litvin tried to find his way to West Berlin on the railway premises between the stations Friedrichstraße and Leerter Bahnhof, which is now Berlin Central Station. He was spotted by the GDR transport police, who were on patrol on the railway viaduct, and he tried to flee by jumping into the water. After two warning shots, they opened fire on him. About 3 hours later, the police recovered his body from the water. Günther Litvin was the first victim that was shot by East German border guards while trying to escape from East to West Berlin. Decades later, after the fall of the Berlin Wall, Günther's younger brother, Jürgen Litvin, managed to save a nearby watchtower from demolishment and set up a small museum dedicated to his brother Günther. Unfortunately, Jürgen Litvin died in 2018, but the museum still exists and is certainly worth a visit. I will leave a link in the text below. To finish the story, in the period that followed after the Berlin Wall was built, protests from the East German population against the closed border was heavily punished. Thousands of people were sentenced to prison because of anti-state agitation, and for the next 28 years, the East German borders remained closed. Okay, now you know how and why the Berlin Wall was built. If you like this video, thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. If you have any remarks or questions, feel free to leave them below, and thank you for watching.